Hey guys, I'm back again. So I just wanted to do a quick little heat test here of the LGG Flex 2 versus the LGG 3 to see which device gets hotter the fastest and is as well as which one is more stable under like a heavy load. So we can use a standard benchmark app here, which is made to stress the devices. And we can cover them up a bit here to protect them because they're not waterproof. So we can start it off about now on both of them and also give them an ice cube each. I can get one. There we go. So I will speed up this video obviously so as not to keep you waiting. And we can see straight away that both of them are getting quite hot here already, heating up there to 40. So it should be quite interesting to see which one gets the hottest and melts the ice cube the fastest. So we're at the 5 minute mark here, and interestingly enough, the G3 seems to be running a bit hotter here than the G Flex 2, which was completely unsurprised. Well, sorry, I'm completely surprised, should I say, because I was expecting the G Flex 2 to really boil the ice cubes, but you can see the ice cube is nearly melting here on the G3, and they've gone through quite a few runs here on this test, so no crashes so far, which is good. And we'll carry on going for a bit to see if the G Flex 2 can maintain quite a nice temperature there, 40 versus 41 here on the G3. So we're at the 12-minute mark here, and we can see we've had a bit of a catastrophe. I did actually see that the battery was running down here on the G3 very fast, and tried to get rid of like an annoying notification. So I did have to kind of move the ice cube a little bit to get at it, and it seemed to went everywhere. But you can definitely see here the ice cube is definitely like half what it was, whereas the one on the G Flex 2 is still quite solid as what it was before. We can see here the temperature is quite weird really, because the temperature's actually been going down here to 38.3 versus 39.9 on the G Flex 2, even though it did start off obviously a bit cooler. However, it did actually crash once on one of the tests. As you can see, the time elapsed is like different with this one on 5 minutes and this one on 13 minutes. This one's been running through it like a pro with no issues whatsoever, so a bit worrying there how we did get a crash here, because this is a stability test obviously, and it does try and work the CPUs as hard as possible. But we can just continue till the end and see what happens. I think that the G3 is going to get rid of the ice cube first, but we never know. So we're getting to the 17-minute mark now on the G3, and as you can see, it's completely melted the ice cube here. So the G Flex 2 is obviously the winner of this test. Looks like the G3 does actually run hotter than the G Flex 2. But it is quite bizarre how this seemed to crash twice. I've had to restart it twice on this test, so maybe the Snapdragon 801 is still a bit more stable overall, even if it does seem to run quite hot. I think that it's definitely allayed my fears though of the Snapdragon 810. Obviously, it does run quite decently in comparison to some older chipsets, as you can see on this video. So yeah, just a quick little video here, looking at the heat of these two devices. Hope you found it informative, and if you did like the video, and I'll see you very shortly. Cheers.